To our fear-drenched communities, and in some not too distant tomorrow, the radiant stars of love, brotherhood, and sisterhood will shine over our great nation and our world with all their scintillating beauty. Therefore, in faith, let us commend ourselves and our work for justice to the goodness of Almighty God. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, this morning we lift up prayers for healing of those who have been mentioned that have been recently been in the hospital. And we also pray for those who may have been released from the hospital a while ago but are still healing. We ask, Lord, for your continued mercy upon those names we lift before. Lord, this morning we remember those who have gone on to be with you from this life into the next. Whether it has been a recent passing or a passing many, many years ago, we thank you for the blessing that they were to us and to others. And we ask for continued presence with their loved ones as they are with you. We name them in our hearts before you now. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us share the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples with the confidence of the children of God. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Comes from Psalm 39, verses 1 through 6 and 13 through 18. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain. For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works that I know very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my unformed substance. In your book were written all the days that were formed for me, when none of them as yet existed. How weighty to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them. I try to count them. They are more than the sand. I come to the end. I am still with you. And now if the children would like to come up and join Pastor Kathy, right up here, we'll have a children's message.
Notes with it. And the other day, he invited a friend to come with him to church. How was it, buddy? That was fun. Did your friend have a good time? Oh, my friend had a good time. What did your friend like? Well, we liked the snacks, we liked the songs, and we liked to play. Wow, it sounds like you had a great time in church, didn't you? Have any of you ever had anybody spend the night and you invited them to church? Have you done that? Yeah, it's pretty fun, isn't it? Have any of you spent the night with your friend and gone to their church? No? Sometimes, yeah. Sometimes some people might, but you brought a friend to church and did they like it? Did you have fun? Awesome. Would you do it again? Yes, this is a great spot. And as we're sitting here, and you remind me, Jason, we have some beautiful things to look up on the wall still from Christmas. Yeah, and it reminds me of Christmas still. And I would even bring my friends here to even see the beautiful sanctuary that we sit in too. It's so beautiful. One of the things that Jesus' disciple named Philip did is he invited his friend Nathan to come and see Jesus. When you think about inviting your friends to church, have you ever thought about inviting them to come see Jesus? Kind of. Well, sometimes it takes steps. Some of us might be ready to invite our friend to come and see Jesus. But some of us may be ready to invite our friend to come to church and to learn about Jesus at church. But however we invite our friends to come and see Jesus, we know that Jesus is with us. And our friends here at church are too. Plus all these people, look around at all these people here. They have all come to worship Jesus and to care for one another and to care for you all too. And for Buddy. So let us pray. Buddy, now this Buddy's just learning how to pray, so I'm going to ask him to put his head down and fold his hands. But you don't always have to do it. You can pray without that. So let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for friends here in church and in our schools and in our neighborhoods. We thank you when we have opportunity to ask them to come and see what we do here at church. And we ask, thank you for opportunities you give us to ask them to come and see you too. In Jesus' name we pray. Candy Zeman comes to share a ministry moment with us about Wesley Covenanters. You go wherever you want and they will find your microphone for you. Except that one. Yeah, one of these. That's all right.
One of these? Good morning. My name is Candy Zeman, and I'm here to invite you to join Wes. Can you hear me? Okay. To invite you, I have a loud enough voice you probably could hear me without the mic, but invite you to join Wesley United Methodist Covenant Group if you haven't. I've been a member of the United Methodist Church for many years, but I had never heard of Wesley Covenant Groups until I moved to Champaign 7 years ago and joined this church. I joined a covenant group, and it's really been the best thing that I've ever done for my spiritual growth. It's allowed me to gain a deeper understanding of the Bible and of prayer, while at the same time making me realize how much more I really need to learn. I try to study the Bible on my own, but I really find that being part of the group is a much better situation, and that I get so much more out of it because of the different perspectives and the different ideas, and that makes me then deeper into the lesson because people bring up so many ideas that I haven't thought of. Additionally, I enjoy the fellowship and the support provided by the group members. It's also been a great opportunity for me to get to know some of the members of the church and to make some new friendships. So today you can sign up in Friendship Center if you have never tried a Wesley Covenant group. I really recommend it. Thank you.
Thank you. And ministry is in motion, as in First Church. It's time to share in our offering this day. As the offering plate comes through, we ask that you will put this yellow sheet in the offering plate, and if you choose to give for Human Relations Day, that offering too. Following the offering, we'll have a few minutes for you to fill out your survey, and then we ask that as you leave the sanctuary this morning that you will put it in one of the baskets as you leave.